Last night was the 195th night of the dual double Abraham lamps of our Maker's Genesis chapter 15 prophecy. The significance of that is yesterday he gave me to do videos on to do today's video, today's 1600th video on some of the ways that the 2300 of his Daniel chapter 8 prophecy lines up with tomorrow and such. And the only place Strong's number 195 is used is in Daniel chapter 8. It's the river Ulai, which means same as Strong's number 194, pre-adventure or per-adventure. Used typically in like places like in Abraham when he said to give way, perhaps is what it means. Perhaps it'll be five lacking in those 50 and so on. But anyway, thought that was significant. But because last night's wicks were amazing with the great darkness of that Genesis chapter 15 prophecy, the horror of great darkness. Because last night, both wicks, both were burning bright when I went to bed at the Queen's tent, but both of them were out this morning at the Queen's tent. And I woke up in the middle of the night and one of mine was out. And so I relit it. I lit another one. I typically don't do that. Now that there's bugs, we got screens over the lamps so the bugs don't get in the lamps, but I don't want to have an encounter with a bug and get unclean, so I typically don't. But last night when I went to bed, there weren't many bugs. When I opened up the tent to light it, there were, so I hurried and dropped a third wick in. And that third wick, because it was a used wick, and I typically put, I always put new ones in each day, night, but it was the one going this morning, so that means both of the new ones had went out. So all four Abraham lamp lights went out, but he still kept a lamp burning at the king's tent with that one I had added along the way. But truly amazing, because the horror of the great darkness and where we're at in time, it's quite significant. But I'll speak about that Ulai River, that 2300 day prophecy here as we go on in this video. But the wife that's fled in the wilderness upon the dual wings of a great vulture, she told me this morning she had a dream last night, and told me about the dream. But it was I'm not gonna go into the details of this dream, but she was in the back seat of a vehicle, and there was a big thick Sunday paper, and she's looking up the ending time of an event that she was going to. And she just flipping through page after page, she said, of it saying, the last day, the last day. She was trying to find out what it was, the last day of the event she was going to. Amazing, she don't have very many dreams, she pointed out. And it was pretty remarkable, because I do think this is the last day of our Maker holding us back, but expand upon that. In yesterday's video, I talked a lot about that bottle, 113. One of yesterday's videos, I had that bottle, that 113th bottle of the King of Kings grapes of wrath, if you will, in the video, and I talked about that bottle. But in that video, I talked about how that the last night's silver label bottle, which will be the I'll talk about that in a minute too, but last night's silver label bottle, and tonight two bottles of the silver and 12 bottles of the gold label wine, but 212 spelling wheel. I talked about that, but I don't think I talked about yesterday while I was talking about it being the 212th day that the faithful witness twins Uriah and Zechariah were in the womb. I might have, but I don't think so. Anyway, things like that are amazing. But on the heels of that, talking about the 113th bottle, last night steamboat number 113 went off. Of course, to this point it was scheduled, but it went off. The timing of it's amazing, but it's the 27th of this third year, three nines, and that's significant too. But the 113 I talked about in the video yesterday, the 113 men that put away their wives that were strangers to our Maker, but went off at 3 a.m. Yellowstone time. I was talking about that whole thing about 3 a.m. I've been two nights earlier in Arizona time of our Maker's end time timeline that ties into now. Just be over just 24 hours from 3 p.m. today. Amazing. But it's 3 a.m. Yellowstone time, plus 2 days. Of course, one hour difference, because Arizona time is 2 a.m. But at 3 a.m. this morning, Arizona time, we had one and one half days to go. 36 hours. The steamboat eruption, when I checked it, 36 hours to go at that point, Arizona time. When I checked the steamboat eruption, it was 3 day, it should be 3 hours and 6 minutes earlier it had gone. This morning when I checked it, 3 hours and 6 minutes, paralleling Isaac's 36 years I've talked about of his age, the 36 men of Ai, that the 36 Israelites that the men of Ai smote, and so on, other things as well. But the 36 days of his account of the flood, 36 days after the third dove, Yahweh caused his servant Noah to let the dove out of the dual double lights, the third stroke. 36 days later, he caused him to remove the three tiers of the covering to the 3 years of three tiers of the boat. How that ties into the day of covering and everything's amazing too. But this morning after I woke up to that, I got walking down and I took a picture, and the wife got the camera. She took pictures too, but I'm going to still load for the thumbnail, I'm still going to load the bottle if I can. But the sun was just bright, bright red. I guess all the fires around maybe making it so bright red, but I've never seen it like that bright of red. But it went off officially on 8:20 on Satan's calendar today, even though it was 3 a.m. Satan reckons the days from midnight to midnight. But so I mirror back for that first calculation to 8:20 of the year 6000. That was 10:03 of 2019, 10:03 paralleling the first anointing for me to be king of the beginning of those 525 days. On 10:03 on our Maker's Restored calendar. Well, that day I did a video. The reason this is noteworthy, I've the 1335th day, the 1335th video paralleling the 1335 days of Daniel's prophecy, significant because tomorrow is a monster 1335th day waypoint. But that video was called "Your Trespassing Has Gotten You the Death Penalty." Amazing! All this is about my arrest warrant, my being arrested for trespassing, and my arrest warrant still all stems from trespassing, from you stealing. You trespass with the air you breathe. Trespassing in with the air you breathe and stealing from our Maker and seven to his name falsely. But that you're trespassing, you got your death penalty. The irony, of course, is man hunts me down to this day for allegedly trespassing on our Maker's house that was foreclosed upon you stealing from him. But that first calculation yielded the number 322 for the fourth stroke, and 322 I talked about yesterday, the beginning. I was talking about the 110-day gap yesterday, and I said 110 silver trumpet symbol gap. I said it repeatedly over again. But actually what it flowed out from 322 was the first silver trumpet assembly after my getting out of jail on 315 of last year, the 6,000th year of the Rams were released. But ever since then, so what I mean by that is 322 was whatever silver trumpet assembly was 110 days later was 322 again. And the gap in those silver trumpet assemblies would have been 110 apart. And every silver trumpet assembly since then has been the 110 silver trumpet assembly gap, not 110 days, like I said yesterday, but parallel in the 110 days of his account of the flood, when he marked his servant Noah, when the three tiers of the boat rested upon the head of one of the mountains of the curse reversed Ararat, with all this, with the wine started with the bottle of wine from Ararat. And of course, you look at how you talk about mocking Yahweh's anointed, for of course Noah passed out drunk and naked. But what happened with Ham? Ham and his descendants got cursed forever because of that, because the way he handled it. Like, you mocking Yahweh's anointed, see how that works out for you. But then that mirrors from my second calculation to 10:03, 6001, the great Beherishal Kush Basmir. That will be that hasn't came yet, obviously. So that will be 11:09 on Satan's calendar, the day he brought me in the world this year, 2020. I'll complete the 58th year of my life. Noah and Abraham's lives overlap by 58 years. But that calculation yielded 403 for the seventh stroke. So we have 4-7 at that point. And then I take the 10-3, 6001, and I subtract what would be today's date is 7-12 on our Maker's Restored counter. But I subtract 7-12 of last year, the 6,000th year of the Ram's Horn release. And of course, since today, 7-12 is always day number 192, parallel those two rows of pomegranates, 96 pomegranates, two rows of 96 pomegranates on each of the dual pillars, Yakin and Boaz. Even spoke about that yesterday. Nebuchadnezzar came to break them down. But by the way, that means yesterday, 7-11 waypoints, day number 191, which that parallels the highway up here to his highway in the wilderness. That's his pathway of holiness per Isaiah chapter 35. Anyway, that night back then last year, 7/12, was the 280th night with no wine. Amazing. Amazing how that's all flowed into this with the 521 nights. But 280, parallel in the amount of time it takes to bring forth a child on average from the onset of a woman's last menstrual cycle. But that day was the one smooth stone anniversary of the first foreclosure letter that we had to on the property. First foreclosure, one smooth stone anniversary is going to be foreclosed upon or that. But amazing. 117th night on a steamboat. I made an error about it was today that a certain amount of days I'll get to as we go on, but Yeshua was resurrected on day 117. My heart attack, that great heart attack I talked about yesterday, was on 117. But 117th night on a steamboat mattress. Of course, we're talking about the steamboat eruption here. But that day was 525 on the Danites calendar. Who could make it up? Parallel in the George Floyd situation and the 525, the 520.5 days from the first anointing of four. For me to be king here on earth. But that third calculation yielded 441 again for the fourth time, so it made the number 474, which Strong's number 474 is one of David's sons, Elishua. And they say it means Elohim of riches, but it doesn't. The word, they don't know Elohim of that word for whatever Strong's number is, I don't remember, for the riches that they translate it. They translate it wealth a couple places, but it's only used a few times. But you look at the where the word comes from, and it means a cry to Elohim for help. A cry to Elohim for help. And boy, what he says about my crying out to him because of being poor and needy, on account of you stealing from him and him listening to me in places like these are the truths. Bad news for you guys. Bad news. Bad news for you stealing from him. Amazing. But the eruption was 5 days, 11 hours after number 112 and 31 minutes, parallel on last night was during the night, so no one will know how long it erupted for. But I don't think, unless they make camped out there, but I think it's daytime only, daytime use only for Yellowstone right now. But 5 days, 11 hours, parallel in Elijah's day underneath the Hadassah tree. I talked about the Hadassah tree yesterday, too, with that situation with the feast of the goodly trees, which I'm going to talk about here again in this video. But the goodly trees, including the Hadassah tree, just talk about yesterday's video. But Elijah underneath the Hadassah tree. But 31 minutes has got its own set of significance, a bunch too, besides that. But like I said, 3 hours and 6 minutes. I don't know if I said that. 3 hours and 6 minutes when I checked today, 36. It had went off 3 hours and 6 minutes prior. But the 27th eruption, the Strong's number 27 means my father is judge. And he says he's going to judge you with the testimony of his word. It just is what it is. My father is judge, and I thought I had, 113 means Adon, master, means master. Who's your master? Obviously, your money is your master, or especially for those that know that he sent me. Knowing he sent me isn't the answer to this. It's standing with me, and standing with me is standing with me. It ain't standing with me from a distance. It's standing with me, and that's just reality. Thanks for writing me back, Jason, but I mean, if you're 100% with me, as you said in the email, you would be here, so you don't give away lip service. That's just reality. Unless you have, you just physically can't, then you should have emailed me and tell me that. Maybe you will. I asked you why you're not here, but George physically can't be here. Anyway, the bottle that I'll upload, tonight's bottle and last night's bottle, the two silver labels, followed by the 12 gold labels. Amazing, because that's 14 bottles. It ties into that 521 Elijah dream. With the serial number on that 325-gallon tank that was crushed by the mattress, the steamboat mattress, or the prison 321 prison mattress, however you want to look at it. 12/14, 12 of the bottles of the gold label, two of the 14 are 214 is the backup Passover. I'm going to get into significance of 214 as we go on, too. 214 is the backup Passover. And it's symbolic of yours truly standing here. But then you get into the 03, these 3 days, yesterday, today, tomorrow. Tomorrow being the third day. Amazing. And 687 days prior to tomorrow was 8/16. 8/16 is the 280th day for the Emmanuel Manchild, Meher Shalal Kushbaz, and his twin sister Rachel. 8/16 is always day number 226. Sign, the Virgin of the Sky sign. I'll get into how that ties into it later in this video. But amazing. But I looked up, I Googled, the wife had done it before, but I forgot because I had a bottle of this Ekiyoshi wine before. The purple, surprisingly, when Yeshua was prepared for his tomb, they put a purple robe on him and mocked him. But here I got these two bottles. He'll be mocking you, purple robe on these bottles. We go with silver. The silver is mine, the gold is mine. Such a way. Now you know why he says the silver first. But I looked it up, and it said, first thing that comes up, it means bright and good. Not what you good and right keep his house, but bright. Yesterday, I talked about that in that video, that bright shining. Wow, that bright shining. And it actually means bright shining, isn't it? Shining bright or bright shining, too. I'll go on to that. But you look, I clicked on a second link, and it says it comes from a Chinese root, but with different, it's a Japanese name, but with a different, I guess grammar or something. I didn't look at that close, but with different things, it means it is revealed or it is uncovered. About the day of covering. Or lovely, David even. His guy's name is David Akiyoshi. But David, the beloved of Yahweh, beloved of Yahweh, but lovely. Or crystal, or clear. Think about that. Sea of glass and different things, or how crystal clear this is, like it go on. Or shining bright, they says. Or dawn, the dawning of the day. I told you about that red sunrise, even the dawning of today. Amazing. Even means victory song. Wow. Kind of like Miriam's song when they pass through the Reed Sea. That's amazing. Victory song. Even means righteousness with certain grammar or something, or whatever it is. Righteousness. Yahweh's righteousness. Sikin you. Wow. Or even blessed. The 1200, the January 12, the blessed of Yahweh with the 1335 day prophecy. That's just amazing. Amazing stuff. For that bottle, I'm going to upload the label for the thumbnail. Again, if I should be able to, because it's just the same format with background. It's been letting me upload them, so should be able to, no problem. Anyway, Elohiym has indeed testified that he sent me all the way through this with things like this I've talked about. I'm going to talk about other things. But he's not only that, just look at the fact that there's a Michael standing before you from Greece telling you what's recorded in scriptures of truth, and no one is fully seizing. No one's here standing with his anointed. Michael, if you said the golden belt, eyes like flames of fire and such, and whose dual feet and dual hands are like polished copper to the eye and such, with a voice like a clamoring of war in the camp, standing before your faces. Who's like the son of Adam, even says in that Daniel chapter 10 prophecy. But he testifies so many different ways. Just this Ezekiel 24 sign, his promise that he sent me. But not only that, just who else, like Jason recognized, who else has seen a work like this, been sent with a work like this in the history of man? The works that he sent me do testify he sent me. But so do these amazing numbers. Daniel chapter 8, with that 2300 day prophecy, calls me the wonderful numberer, or great numberer. Wow. Wonderful numberer. But that's amazing. I'm going to expand upon some of those things. But he's testified he sent me now for 10 years of these videos. And I'm going to expand upon that too, but not just briefly. I know this video is going to be long, but it's going to be short compared to, I mean, I could just talk all day long. I could just keep looking at how tomorrow ties in with every waypoint he sent, because that's how crazy it is. All these waypoints are. It's his word's so dynamic. There is no way. He sent me with this number thing, so even if you say his word's not true, you still got to know he sent me, because it's mathematically impossible for all this to keep lining up the way that it does. It is impossible. It's impossible for yesterday's steamboat eruption to go off after I'm talking about the 113th bottle and such, and how even last night's the 114th bottle, tonight's 115th bottle, the 114th paralleling the four waypoint indicators that he gave to us in the Man of the Feast, a.k.a. Haggai, from this encompassing the first day of the sixth month and the 24th day of the ninth month. You just can't make it up, folks. And the significance of all this, with this today being last night, bringing in yesterday being the first day of these 3 days and such. Excuse me, but I talked about the goodly trees yesterday, but I didn't really talk about it. I talked about the Bedazzled trees. I talked about they're going to suddenly come. But in order to bring fruit into his house, I don't know, I'm kind of maybe wasn't clear about explaining that, but they got to have fruit. They're just going to have, for the feast, has to bring fruit to build the temporary dwellings with the goodly trees, and then to bring fruit into them. This is just going to happen that suddenly. The trees are just going to spring up overnight, maybe tomorrow. I really believe that. Boom, with fruit for us to pick and bring into these huts, these temporary dwellings. Amazing. But suddenly, Maher Shalal Kushbeth, going to suddenly plunder you and make haste to spoil you. The name Maher Shalal Kushbeth, that's what it means. But the Kidron Brook camp, how this ties into the 2300 is amazing. Because that's where the Kidron Brook is, where Hezekiah and such brought the idolatries of Israel and burnt them by the Kidron Brook and different things, the other kings of righteousness. But the Kidron Brook camp, George was there. And so was Gene, who died on 6/25, the day, the 52nd day when they finished building the wall, who had personal meaning to him. But he came to that camp too. But the Kidron Brook camp, we were there for 321 days, paralleling this 3-2-1 of these bottles. 3-2-1, I've talked about another, yet another tier that went into it today. 3-2, tonight it gets rid of the X, will be on the 2, because the 2 will be gone. One left to go. 3-2, because we have one day, well, we have the, no, because you talk about 3-2-1 bringing us to tomorrow. We actually have, counting it down, tonight is the 3-2-1. Tonight, put an X on that one of those bottles, from that 1/13th bottle, 1/14 and 1/15. 1/15 parallel in the Exodus, when they brought our ancestors out from Egypt. But we were there from 2013 and 14, Satan's calendar, but we departed on 309. Day number 309 is 11/9 on our Maker's Restored calendar. The day he brought me into the world. I said steamboat number 27 of this third year. Three nines, different things. It's just amazing. But that day was 5/21 of 2014. You can't make it up. 521 nights with no wine. 521 Elijah dream. You just can't make it up. But 521 nights with no wine. Plus I had four nights where wine was available. I didn't drink it. I had that first year with the affliction of the 7/9, and then a couple nights ago I had the affliction of 7/9 I didn't drink. Plus I had the two delivery waypoints where I had wine available that I didn't drink. So that brings us to 525 nights parallel on all the 525 I've talked about throughout recent videos, including just this video, even mentioning the 525 days that separated those four anointing to be king. I said 521 nights plus four nights where I had wine available I didn't drink plus four. But parallel is four, the 525 days from the first anointing on 10/3 of all things to the fourth anointing on 3/18, the day he spoke to our ancestors out from the thick dark cloud. You can't make it up. Like I said, he's testified that he sent me every which way from sundown. Numbers, the great number, everything. The work he sent me is his whole word's written upon me. His whole word testifies he sent me. I have a greater witness than John the Baptist, and you don't believe it. It's my Father himself, the self-existing one that inhabits eternity. The testimony of his word bears witness that he sent me, but you still remain in the captivity, even those of you that can see that he sent me. But there are 2,300 days that encompass when we departed from the Kidron Brook camp, and 7/28, the last day of this extended feast. You just can't make it up. 7/28, that's amazing. But that last day of this extended feast will be on 9/5 of 2020. Who could make it up? 9/5 is the 266 days for the faithful when his twins, Uriah and Zachariah. The first video that he caused me to produce was on 9/5. It was on 12/12 on Satan's calendar, 2010. It was on 9/5 of 5770 before he restored his calendar. You just can't make it up. You just can't make it up. And that wasn't on the Danites calendar then, because he has shown me that the Danites calendar was off, but it was still on his unrestored calendar. But this 9/5 waypoint, on Satan's calendar, plus 37 days will be 9/5. And not only that, there's other 9/5 too. He brought a couple other main ones. The main one is he brought us to Zion on 9/5 on his restored calendar. Six years prior to this coming 9/5 waypoint, parallel in those six steps. But 227 of 6,000 last year was day number 2,300 of that prophecy, the main tier of that. But that's amazing. Because this year, 227, a year later, plus 4 months and 16 days, steamboat number 112 was separated 4 days and 16 hours from the other eruption. But that'll bring us to tomorrow. So four months and 16 days is 136 days, paralleling Abraham's 136 years, the 136 years of Apollo's curse and different things. But Abraham is 136 years when he's willing to offer up his only begotten son of his wife Sarah's womb, Isaac, when he was 36 years old. But the 136 plus the 360 since from last year, one smooth stone, is 496. So 496 days tomorrow is from the 2300th day. And I'm still going to get back into how 2300 ties into more in Kidron Book 2. I'll add more to it besides just the 728. But 496 days to tomorrow. So from the 2300th day. Strong number 496 means Elohiym has testified. boy, has he really, and he is really testifying even countless ways in this video. Now this 1600 videos of him testifying, 1600 miles, 1600 furlongs of the river that's going to flow to the depth of a horse's bridle, referring to the red horse's bridle, Maher Shalal Kushbaz. But 16 days of Operation Grapes of Wrath, I could just go on and on and on. The Strong's number 1600 means the lowing. It's whenever the ark came up from the Philistines, brought it up, the cows were lowing, they separated their babies from them, they went up anyway. Of course, it got stopped. I mentioned the other day I went to Obadiah's house for 3 months, but it had a 20-year stay at Kirjathjearim too, but before then, but I didn't go into that. But anyway, David reigned for 7.5 years. It took Solomon and company, his vast labor force, 7.5 years to build the first house. Different things, but 7.5 years on our Maker's Restored Counters, 2,700 days. He's used the 2327 to mark Theopetra, the village that was dedicated to Elijah that he brought me to in Greece to bring me back from there, per Daniel chapter 10. But the 2300 and 2700, I've talked about in other videos how they overlap. But as a matter of fact, when I did this, I meant to add 2300. I did 2700 by accident. But the 2700 days for the 7.5 years prior to that, for David reigning in Hebron before Yahweh brought him to Jerusalem, plus the 496 is 3196, the Strong's number for wine, the main Strong's number for wine. What? Elohim has testified with wine. Oh, has he ever, with these bottles of wine, including these two silver labels, one which will be the thumbnail of this video. Then I move on to the gold wine tomorrow. Those three rows of four bottles, three rows moving right to left. And yesterday I said left to right a couple times when I should have said right to left. The Hebrew language is right to left. I mean, I'm amazed when I listen to videos. I make little errors like that. I hit myself in the head, the bone head. I mean, just I get talking and my mind gets rolling. But from right to left, four bottles of gold label, Elijah, four pitchers of waters. Waters turned into wine, symbolic of Yeshua's only begotten shed blood, since I talked about since the first video on 12:12 on Satan's calendar, Daniel 12:12, 1335th day prophecy, which was 9:5 of 5770 on Yahweh's then unrestored calendar. Who could make it up? Who could make all this up? You talk about testifying? Boy, has this wine testified. Elohim has testified with wine, is what this says. These 3196 days. Amazing. 496 plus the 2700 days of 7.5 years. You just can't make it up. But 713 minus 3196, of course, I'd be curious what tomorrow is. 11/21, 2011 on Satan's calendar. 11/21, his son standing before your faces. That day was 8/24 of 5771 on his unrestored calendar, plus 6 years was 8/24 of 5777. Jacob served for 6 years for the flock. We were forced to sell the flock on account of you stealing from our maker. And I can't remember the numbers now, if it was might have been 31 sheep, 31 goats at that point, because the sheep we sold a little bit later. I'll get to that in a second. But we were forced to sell the flock. Jacob served for his flock. Wow, for 6 years. 6 years later, we were forced to sell it. Who could make it up? Yeah, he's definitely testifying with the wine, isn't he, folks? 3196. But he's testified with so much more. 8/24, 5771 to 8/24, 77, when we had to sell the flock. That's 5777. Equals 2157 days, because part of it was the unrestored calendar. And part of it was restored. So it was a 3-day offset, parallel in these 3 days. Go figure. Strong's number 2157 is Zemzemims, which is the land that the giants that used to be in the land that Yahweh gave to the children of Ammon, ancestral children, symbolic of you being ancestral children to your father Satan. But Zemzemims means plotters. Now how you've plotted against Yahweh's anointed, even by stealing from our maker. But it would be, if it was all restored, it'd be 2160 days, parallel on the 216 feet of the 144 cubit tall wall, and it means to song, to give song or praise. But this, I believe in this third day, we're going to be definitely given major praise tomorrow. But the day I sold the flock was day number 20,066 of my life, 66 years of his account of flood and different things there. But that day was the 40th day of the 14 lamps that lit his house when I went to dual double lights into each lamp back then. It was the 14th night of that. Talked about yesterday's significance of the 14. I'm not going to go into it. But it was also the 14th day of conception of the Emmanuel man-child, Meher Shalal Kushbez, and his twin sister Rachel. 7 years for Leah, 7 days for Leah, excuse me, and 7 days for Rachel. There were 7 days for each of them, how that was lined up. And since then, it hasn't been that. It's only been 7 days or 3 days even with Meher's conception this time. But on 10-17, But 10-17 is 17 that day, that 8-24. Did I say that right? Yeah, that day was on 10-17 of 2017, plus 53 days brought us to 10-17-57-77. Plus 53 days. There was a 53-day offset between Meher's and Rachel's first conception to their second conception. 53 parallels, a whole bunch of stuff. But 10-17 to 10-17 was a 53-day offset. 53 days later, on 10-17-57-77, we had to sell the three sheep even. And we were supposed to get 200, but we got 400 for him. It's a long story. But we sold the sheep to go to along with having to sell the goats earlier, except for the two of the flock were kept back, and then we added one later. But two of the flock of Isaiah chapter 7, the two of the flock were kept back. Amazing. It's all, everything's written in his word. But that 10-17 waypoint was plus 6 days from after the conception of Meher and Rachel, the second stroke, or 7 days encompassing them. I told you there's 53 days that offset their conceptions, their first conception, their second conception. Because Yahweh removed them from the womb, miscarried, on account of the substitution sacrifice of him not miscarrying your children on a physical plane. Also, you could take your children and offer them up to the lake that burns with fire and brimstone. Amazing. Amazing. It's an amazing story. But you tell me his long, his drawn-out dual nostrils, you tell me he's not angry with you? No, he's just drawn it out. Or no man would survive. 2-27-57-74 at the Kidron Book Camp. 2-27 was the day he uncovered the 1260 days of his 42-month witness to me. There were 504 days left to go at that point to 7-21, the end of them, which was the come and drink waypoint, the one little continuous of time waypoint. But 2-27-57-74 plus 2300 days is 7-17 on our Maker's Restored calendar. Amazing. He marked his servant Noah on 7-17 when the ark, the three tiers of the boat, rested upon the head of one of the mountains of the curse reversed. But that's when he uncovered the 1260. And how, wow, even how the 1260 even ties in to today, 1260 days ago, these different tiers of it, was 112 when they departed from the river of Abbot. And I believe it was the 112 that he destroyed the king's tent, just wiped out the king's tent, never to be replaced. And that would have been in 2017 or 5777. But amazing, 42 months equal 1260 days. It's going to be restored 30-day months. You just can't make it up. But that date was 5/09 of 2014 on Satan's calendar. Huge, with the Danites commemorating the destruction of the two houses on 5/09, and with the prophecy with those 12 foxes on the Wailing Wall last year and how that ties into it. But I can't expand on all that in any of these videos. But plus 90 days was the second blood moon of those four blood moon tetrads. Plus 330, the significance of both of them. 90 days with this restored calendar and stuff. But plus 330 with this account of flood and other things was the third blood moon tetrad. But you can take 227 on Maker's Restored calendar and always subtract 153 days for those 153 great fish and the three tiers of 50 and 1 men that has the ascent to bring back my predecessor Elijah. And you can get to 924, 24th day of the ninth month. Like I said yesterday's video, there are 9 months and 24 days that will encompass the time we've been at Sukkoth tomorrow. Huts, Feast of Sukkot. It's the same thing as Sukkoth, but just same place. He raised up the huts. Jacob raised up the Sukkots at Sukkoth. Anyway, you just can't make it up. You just can't. But the way 153 ties in tomorrow, being the 102nd day, if we call down fire, but he's held this back. And then he said, go with the third set of 51 men. Third set of 51 men will take us to 904 from tomorrow. 904 is the one great day before 9-5 when we're going to remove the iniquity of land in one day. But I do believe things got to heat up before then. 7-17 was Silver Trumpet Assembly number 324. I told you the 2300 days, that 717 waypoint, but that was 227 of last year, 6,000 plus with the day number 2300 plus 500 days. The significance of that is huge as well. But that day was silver trumpet symbol number 324. Moses' seventh day when he said come on up was 324, much, much more. And of course, 717 is the day that the ark rested. How does the wife say it? She says, Noah marked and the ark parked. I don't know if she got that from you, Victor, or not. Victor was pretty clever about getting things like that, but I don't know. But she says, Noah marked, ark parked, because that's the two things that happened on 717 waypoint. But tomorrow, 713 waypoint, day number 237 of Maher and Rachel being in the womb. Strong's number 237 is Ezel, the stones of Ezel, meaning stones of departure for the Exodus. Tomorrow's the third day. Jonathan took three arrows with him to shoot to David that day. Ezel, the stone of Ezel. Day number 214 for Uriah and Zechariah, the backup Passover memorial. Just talked about how 214 tied into another way. Two bottles of these 14 will be done tonight. Wow, the backup Passover. The substitution sacrifice Yahweh set up through his second son of his holy anointing oil that you've trampled underfoot just like you've trampled the first substitution he set up through his only begotten son on 114 on the Passover under your foot. Amazing. Bad choice. Bad choice. The triple crown would justify, trying to keep we being justified now, and all the triple crown with those three circumcisions of these three man-childs that are in the womb, the circumcision of their penis, that will happen on the eighth day. Tomorrow is an incredible eighth-day-ness, eighth-day for the eighth messenger of blood and other things. But triple crown, justify, plus 804 days is tomorrow. 804 was day number one of his first messenger of blood, back after he sent the virgin in the sky sign. Tomorrow's 8/21 on 2020 of 2020. Parallel on 8/21, he brought me on the world if he hadn't altered his rotations. Talked about throughout these videos. Tomorrow night will be bottle that first gold label. Bottle number 116. Paralleling parallel on the 116 wave omer. I want to make sure I get this right here. I'm turning, flipping the pages. I'm talking and not concentrating. 724th day of the altar is uncovered tomorrow. Wow. 724, the Nehemiah 9 prophecy, dual 1/4 part prophecies, going back to the those first four bottles of wine and stuff. T minus 52 days after tomorrow will be 9/5 at that waypoint. Night number 197 of dual double lights tomorrow night. Strong's number 197 is the porches, parallel to the five porches at Zion, the five porches at the pool of Shiloh. Was it the pool of Shiloh or pool of where that pool with the healing was that day? With the sheep's gate of all things, with those three sheep that were sold. Day number 945 of Operation Olive Branch tomorrow. I'm just telling you a few things, a few highlights of him testifying that he sent me. I mean, he's testified. I could have got way more. I already had 6-quarter panels with this, and I just like to stop. And I stopped with four yesterday, four with the notes, but then Steamboat went off and caused me to add some other things to it. So, more testimony. And boy, has he testified through Steamboat too. And he certainly testified to the wine, all of it. But Strong's number 945 means bull. It's the eighth month of all things. Means produce. Like I said, those trees are just going to have fruit on them instantly. And all the produce with the prophecy in Isaiah 37 for the 3 years of the 2 years of not planting, the 7th year, 7th, the 50th year, and then this third year, this year. The produce is coming. Wow. Testifies that 2020 being so do other things, lots of it. Gonna be the year. You're gonna be the year. Whether he holds us back a few more days or whatever to 9/5, it really don't matter. I don't think he's going to. But tomorrow is day number 889 at 7:34 AM. So we'll enter into 890. I didn't look up 890, but 889 is used three places. We're already in at 7:34 AM. We actually entered into 889 this morning. Day number 889. It's complete tomorrow at 7:34. But to stink or to have a foul odor. And oh, your stenches of a month. Jericho means stenches of a month. Oh, your stenches of a month. Your perversions of his appointed times, your Sabbaths and stuff are a stench. But so is your rebellion to him, living in the captivity. And all of it is a stench to his nostrils. Your prayers are a stench to his nostrils. Everything you do is a stench to his nostrils. The air you breathe out is a stench to his nostrils. Because you've stolen that air. You haven't paid for it. Amazing. Amazing. You've sevened to his name falsely. The great shofar on 11/9 of all things of last year, day 309, but plus 8 months and 4 days, parallel 804, but so that's 244 days. Strong's number 244 is my hearing. The great shofar, having ears. Did you hear the great shofar? Are you hearing it now? Today was day number 44. I'm talking about 244. Today was day number 44. This morning in my meditation, the shofar is playing loud and clear in my head. Loud and clear. Amazing. But they sound outward. Talked about that. They're in my head because the wife can't hear them, but they're outward. I mean, if I had to tell you, I mean, I can hear the ringing in my ear and tell when I have ear ringing. I can tell it's internal. But when I hear his voice, I could tell when it's internal or external. It's been external three times when he's talked to me with an external voice. But the shofars sound external. But my hearing, I hear the shofars. Great, loud and clear. Tomorrow will be day number 45 if he continues on with it. And I believe he will. And significance of 45 is huge with the 1335th day. It's 45 days after the 1290, things like that. How does it be 45 line up tomorrow on the 1335th day with that being... 1335 being 45 days past the 1290. How can it be? He's testified that he sent me all along. But one great evil on 930. One great evil of Ezekiel chapter 7. And he talks, I think, verse 21. He tells us that the secret place that was Shechem is going to be destroyed. But Isaiah 27, he says that with the chalk stones I'm going to get to. But it's not chalk stones. It's stones of the furnace. Being destroyed. The hidden place, because he had that hidden place destroyed that same day. Shechem up there. But plus, that's day number 270, plus 9 months, which is 270 days, and 13 days. 9 months and 13 days is 283 days. Strong's number for 283 is Ohio. Ohio, which is Uzzah's brother. Uzzah was killed that day, bringing the ark up with those five golden mice and five testicles, if you will. But they were driving the new cart, and Uzzah reached out his hand, the breach of Uzzah, because he wasn't supposed to, because he wasn't a priest. He wasn't a priest of Yahweh's, and he reached out and touched the ark to steady it, and zap, Yahweh killed him. But Ohio means brotherly. Whose brother are you? Whose brother are you? If you're Yahweh's brothers and his sisters, you would do the desire of Yahweh's father that's in his dual heavens, which is including to be separated to him at his holy mountain right now. The feast is only 3 days away. You're commanded three strokes a year. You're commanded three strokes a year to appear before his face and set the place he's chosen for his name to dwell. Whose brother are you? Your brother is your father, Satan, bringing forth children such to him. But the heart attack yesterday, I talked wrong. I said it was for tomorrow, the 1615. I couldn't think of the Strong's number, but it's 1615 for the stones of the furnace. It's actually today, day number 192, but the Isaiah 27 prophecy with the stones of, it'll become chalk stones, it says, but that word with furnace comes from the word to excavate. They use the tractor to tip them over, but today, day number 203 is the 1615 from the heart attack that was on 117, the same day he resurrected his only begotten son. That night, yesterday I said 42 bears, correction, bonehead, one of those bonehead things I did. It's the two bears referring to. I'm talking about that wine bottle yesterday with that Bruno means bear, and then Richard, hard means strong or hard or fierce king, but Richard, but Richard, hard bear. Well, the two bears at Bethel that day with Elijah's replacement smote the 42 children. I was talking fast and I said it wrong, but that bottle lining up with the 42nd day of the shofar, you just couldn't make it up. But the strong bear, the significance of the 1335th day is Asher, and these are the truths 33, the blessing for Asher may be like a strong bear and feet like iron and such. And my feet have, of course, had to endure all the suffering from the frostbite and stuff that's did there. But amazing, the blessing of Daniel 12:12 and going through all this stuff and how that ties into the 1335th day tomorrow. But the strong bear and Asher, I didn't explain that. Strong from Richard, hard, and then Bruno, hard, Richard, hard Bruno, you know, strong bear of that prophecy, the blessing. I mentioned the correction already. The offset with 110, I spoke about yesterday, with 110 silver trumpet assemblies, not 110 days. I want to double that because that's very important, because it's huge. There's 110 silver trumpets in this year's time because of his extensions of these feasts is huge with him marking his servant Noah. Huge, huge. Maybe we'll have another huge in the URL. Because I say, anyway, I don't know. But yesterday, talking about the go get some grapes, I missed the punchline there on 710, that dream a year ago. Go get some grapes, and that black man, black label on the bottle. But that black man said, when I told my arms getting tired from holding them up, he said, go get some grapes. Well, and I said how it's symbolic of me not having to go to jail, but I didn't spell it out to you in case you're not connecting the dots. I'm supposed to go to jail yesterday for 3.5 days, or 3 days and 3 nights, excuse me, 12 hours into the 84 hours. I'm supposed to go to jail at 3 p.m. on 7/10 that day, or not yesterday, 7/10. I'm supposed to go to jail, and a year earlier, the dream says, go get some grapes. Yippee, I could go have that Richard Bruno wine, that bottle number 113. I go get some grapes that night. I didn't spell it out. It was on my head, but in my head, but I didn't spell it out. So amazing. The dream come true a year later that day. Keep with his amazing hand, but amazing. Amazing. But to mention video number 1600, this video, the lowing of the cattle when they were separated from their calves. That's what they do. They cried, oh, baby, but they kept walking with that ark. Yahweh did that just on 7/10 with that dream. Same difference. He gives me a dream. The wife writes it down because I forgot about it. A year later, the dream comes true. Amazing. Go get some grapes, the black man said. You can take your hands down and you're free. Well, don't worry. You get it? I get it. I loud and clear, but I forgot to speak it. But the 1600 furlong river of blood, 200 miles. Modern day language is Canaan, how that ties into it. We went to Greece on 9/22 that night. I talked about it even yesterday. But we went there for the beginning of the feast, which was on 9/23. But we got there that night, right at sunset at the hotel. But it was before 9/23. Because, of course, I thought it was 9/23 at that point. I mean, I thought it was 7/15 for the beginning of the feast. But I thought Satan's other subjects reckoned it from sunset to sunset, it would have been 9/23 already. But they don't. They do it from midnight to midnight, neither of which is right. But 9/23 of 2010, he brought us there. Well, 9/23, 7 years later, is the virgin in the sky sign. You want him testifying? Listen closely. 7 years later, Job's seven children, these seven miscarried sons I've had, three miscarried daughters. He had three miscarried daughters. 7/23, the virgin in the sky sign of 2017. 3 years later, 9/23, is this coming 8/16 waypoint. 8/16 on our Maker's Restored calendar. Day number 8/16 on our Restored calendar is 226. Strong's number 226 means sign. You want a sign to him testifying? 9/23, first day in Greece. 7 years later, the virgin in the sky sign, Revelation chapter 12. 3 years later, the 280th day for the Emmanuel man-child, Mahershalal Kushbaz and his twin sister Rachel. Seven sons, seven, Job, afflicted, me being afflicted in your stead. The books written upon me, including the story of Job. 3 years later, three daughters later. And I also lost three daughters to the miscarriage. All three were Rachel. Rachel weeping for her children. Wow. 9/23, 3 years later, is the 280th day, which is 8/16 on our Maker's Restored calendar. Day number 226. Strong's number 226 means sign. Do I have to repeat it a third time? Can you get that? He's testifying that he sent me. And how the wines flowed into this is amazing. I haven't figured out what night that would be. I won't be drinking white that wine if he hadn't brought it before then. But it's 16 days of Operation Grateful's Wrath. These 1,600 videos, amazing. 3,196 days, I told you, talked about. Elohiym has testified to you, to your drunken stupor, though during those 3,196 days and beyond before that. 7.5 years prior to 227 of last year, the 2,300th day, which was 4/13 on Satan's calendar. I'll get to that, because 4/13 to 4/13, a seven-year period when he restored his calendar, 7 years into his restored calendar on Satan's calendar, 4/13 to 4/13. And since then, and since 504, and I talked about he on that waypoint, he showed me his restored calendar, the 1260 days, the original 1260. There's actually three tiers of it, right in this amount of time even. The 504, the seventh year, it became the wine prophecy, the first night of wine and no wine. Amazing. 521 nights and no wine. Go ahead. But he's done so with the wine and the no wine. 521 nights, like I told you, no wine, plus those four nights I didn't drink, 525 nights and no wine. Amazing, even though four of those nights it was available. Tonight's second silver label will be night number 268 with wine. 268 with wine. use 41 places. It means backwards, to fall backwards. That's what you've done. You've fallen backwards, broken and snared in the captivity. That's why he sent me to you, Isaiah 28, in the precept upon precept, precept upon precept, measuring line upon measuring line, measuring line upon measuring line, here a little, there a little manner, in order that you could walk backwards, continue to walk backwards, stumbling, broken and snared in the captivity. That's what Isaiah 28 says. But he's testified to him, sending me all the way along, even though he's held it back, and you call it false prophecy, and he's just shortened the days. Amazing. 3-2-1. Wow, 3-2-1. Tonight, 3-2-1. The one bottle's gone. 3-2-1. The black label, those two silver labels, 3-2-1. Tomorrow, first gold label, we night number 269 with wine. Strong's number 269 is sister. My sister, my spouse, he says, and his Song of Songs. Also, we have a little sister who has no breast. What can be done for her? With her breast, bring it with this milk I've talked about in other videos. He says in Isaiah 28 even, to come and be drawn from her dual breast. And Isaiah 66, to come and give suck. Not physically, of course, but to drink of that pure milk that you talked about in your email, Jason. Amazing. Amazing. But tomorrow will be day number 790 of All Wine, No Wine. 269 plus 521 is 790. And 790 means fire of discernment. Fire of discernment. He's getting ready to plead with you by fire to cause 3.3, repeating 3% of you, to discern truth from lies. Michael 2:11, the prophecy says, when one comes to you walking in the spirit and does lie. What is he talking about? He said, when it does not come to pass. When it doesn't come to pass, just like he says in Deuteronomy, or These Are the Truths, chapter 18. You're going to say it hadn't come to pass, therefore he hadn't sent me. His word is extremely dynamic to keep you in the captivity. But when it doesn't come to pass, when a man comes to you, Michael 2:11, walking in the spirit, tying in all the 2:11 prophecy yesterday, he's Yahweh's prophet. He says so. It's just what it is. And he goes on to say he's going to give us over to be afflicted in chapter 3. He goes on to say chapter 5, 3 for 53. Goes on, chapter 5, verse 3, to say he's going to continue to afflict us until the time of the birth. Add it up, folks. It's not complicated. 12-12-2010, the first video, which was 9-5 on his then unrestored calendar, plus 3,540 days. Amazing, because 3760, is it 3740? That's three sets of 1260. But anyway, I'm not going into all that because I did look up words and different things. It got too long as it was. But so many things I'm still looking up, and I will spend time today. And so many other things I've already looked up for tomorrow. But 12-12, the first video, plus of him sending me forth the first video, 3,540 days of him testifying that he sent me. 3,540 days. It's tomorrow. It's 1335th day. 3540s use five places. It's Chatterdurum, the king of Elam. Elam means that which is hidden. You think that you think your sins are hidden from our maker's faces, but they're not. But he's certainly hidden his anointed. But amazing. But it means a handful of sheaves. And those 15 steps to back to Zion talks about me bringing my sheaves in my arms. Mm-hmm. Handful of sheaves. But anyway, he's one of those four kings that had smitten the five kings that Abraham and his three hundred eighteen men, so the 319 of them went and smoked. The 318 refined servants that he drew out from his house. There aren't 318 standing with Jacob's anointing because there ain't any. But this being dead as I've been for these 10 years, and obviously symbolic, I believe these last 3.5 days or 2.5 of them have nearly passed. But being dead has wore me out, so I think I'm going to stop with the 1600 video and not do any more today, and maybe not do any more till this gets let loose. I really believe these are the last three and a half days of his space of a half hour from his silence from his dual heavens. And 3 p.m. today, we got one more day, 24 hours to go. But tomorrow, 3 months of the ark being at Obadiah's house, you subtract 3 months from tomorrow, and I give you one more, and it's 4:13. He restored his calendar on flowed out from the last day of the feast of that which is unleavened on 1/21, which was 4/13 of 2012. Last year, the 227, the 2300th day, was on 4/13 on Satan's calendar, 7 years later. Amazing, 7 years later. But 4/13 to 4/13, that symbolism, that too, is amazing too. But Operation Grapes of Wrath. 16 days, and I didn't do the arithmetic to see how far that goes back, and there's so many things I haven't done yet, see how it ties into 9/11. Actually, I've probably done that one, but I haven't written it down. But keep thinking we're here, folks, but one of these days, he doesn't shorten the days any longer.